Well, hello there, guys, and welcome back to Hogwarts Legacy. Today, we are getting into part 15, or at least I hope so. And we don't start going into side quests. We'll see. All right. But anyways, let's get into it.
Adventure, are we?
Might some kind soul help me?
Over here.
Sebastian, it's been a while.
It has. Glad you received my owl. I have something to show you.
First, let me thank you for what you did in the library.
Of course. Scribner tried to give me detention, but I have ways out of these things.
Well, you took the fall for me, and that counts for something.
Did you find what you were looking for?
I did, but something was missing. I'm not sure here is the best place to discuss it.
Understood. We can talk more in a moment, in the Undercroft. Not even the professors know about this place. This way. There's a secret passage just here.
It's well disguised. How did you find this place?
My friend, Ominous Gaunt. He named it the Undercroft. We used to play gobstones here all the time. With my sister, Anne. She loved that infernal game. What I wouldn't give to lose to her again. I should tell you, I swore to Ominous I would safeguard this place. So please, keep this between us. He never confides in anyone. But he's trusted me since the day we met. I wouldn't want to jeopardize that. We used to sneak in here almost daily. We've never been caught.
Revelio.
I think I've seen Ominous in potions. Or was it herbology? I've noticed that he uses his wand to navigate the castle.
He does. No idea how, though. Ominous was born blind, and no spell could reverse it. His wand seems almost sentient. Not surprising, I suppose. Ollivander always says, the wand chooses the wizard.
Is that how he found this place?
No, someone in his family knew about it. The Gaunts are full of secrets. I've never heard anyone else speak of it. And I've certainly never seen anyone else here. Again, mention this to no one, especially Ominous. He has no love lost for his family or their secrets, but this place is special to him.
Understood. But why does Ominous have no love lost for his family?
His father's family are direct descendants of Salazar Slytherin, one of the four founders of Hogwarts. Obsessed with blood status, most of them. Ominous cannot abide them. As he'll be the first to tell you. Anyway, the Undercroft has been a perfect place to sneak off to, away from prying eyes, and even practice otherwise forbidden spells.
Really? Like what?
Like the Blasting Curse. Professors say it's not an appropriate spell to teach students.
It sounds like a dangerous spell.
You sound like Ominous. He frowns upon using forbidden spells. Although he did enjoy learning this one, A spell like Confringo is only truly dangerous in untrained hands. Such spells should be properly taught, not banned. To be fair, I'm admittedly partial to more fiery forms of magic, but you should learn it. I can teach it to you safely here. It may take a while to get the feel for it. Mimic my wand movement. The incantation is Confringo.
Very well.
You're getting it. Ready to actually try it out? Stick to the target. Best to keep the Undercroft intact. Have a go at those candelabras. Both have their uses, but I think you'll find that a Confringo cast travels a bit farther than that of a spell like Incendia.
Confringo!
Nice work. How's it feel?
It's a tad hot.
You'll get used to it. That's it!
I think I've got it.
Well done.
I have to say, I enjoyed that.
The first time Ominous and I practiced Confringo, we singed our eyebrows.
I would have paid to see that.
I swore we'd never live it down. So this day, there's something about that spell that's addictive.
This is exactly the type of magic I've been hoping to learn.
There's more where that came from. Been practicing similar spells here for ages. Although, I didn't tell Anne and Ominous about every one. Haven't been here in some time. It's not the same without Anne.
I'm sorry about your sister. If there's anything I can do...
Perhaps when I next head to Feldcroft, you could come along. Meet Anne. She could use some cheering up.
Just let me know when and I'll meet you.
Oh, she misses Hogwarts. She's been stuck at home with our guardian, Uncle Solomon. Unfortunately, you'll have to meet him too. Well, meeting a new student will be precisely what she needs.
I shall look forward to it.
Cheers. By the way, what was it you couldn't discuss out in the hall earlier?
I'm not sure where to start.
You said something was missing from what you found in the library. Might it have something to do with Victor Rookwood? He didn't mistake you for someone else at all in Hogsmeade, did he?
Nothing gets past you. I'll tell you what I can. Rookwood and Ranrock are trying to recover something they think I took from a vault in Gringotts.
Gringotts? When were you there?
Professor Fig and I wound up there after the dragon attack. There was this portkey that...
A portkey? To Gringotts?
Well, it's all a bit convoluted.
I'm listening.
You must promise to keep this between us.
I trusted you with knowledge of this secret Undercroft. You can trust me.
All right. I can see traces of ancient magic.
Ancient magic? I don't know what I was expecting you to say, but it wasn't that. What does that even mean?
Honestly, I'm not entirely certain. All I know is that I can see whispers of an old magic that hardly anyone else can. Fig and I think that Ranrock has somehow found a way to harness that magic's power.
Are you telling me that goblins may be wielding some sort of wizard magic?
That's what we're trying to find out.
And this ability of yours, does this allow you to wield this magic too?
I don't know.
Well, when you do know, tell me. I've been studying archaic forms of magic for ages. Perhaps we can help each other. In the meantime, with both Rookwood and Ranrock after you, I suspect a bit more time practicing the blasting curses in order. Spend as much time here as you'd like. And remember, keep this place between us. When I head to Feldcroft, I'll send you an owl.
Alright, so I have to admit, I'm actually really happy he taught me that one, because I think I'm able to level that up, ain't I? And it's in spells, right? Confringo. Yeah. Packs fiery bolts. Yeah, bro. Yeah. Hell yeah. That's dope. So we're actually going to do this and then... Oh, wait. Oh. Well, we have to finish.
Hello, Sebastian. Wait. You there? I can hear you.
Oh, hello. Ominous, isn't it? I believe we have potions together. And herbology?
I recognize that voice. Heard you talking to Gareth Weasley in potions class. You're the new fifth year. Did you just come from the Undercroft? How did you get in there?
That room's called the Undercroft. Ah, well, I was exploring and then suddenly found myself in a strange passageway.
Don't lie to me. No one stumbles upon that room. Sebastian told you, didn't he? You breathe a word about this place to anyone, and not even your precious Professor Fig will be able to help you. My father is friends with the headmaster. I'm not afraid to exploit that connection if I need to.
Trust me, Ominous. I won't say a word. And Sebastian is a good friend. You shouldn't immediately assume the worst of him.
I don't need you to tell me about my oldest friend. Thank you very much.
Ominous, I just meant...
I know what you meant. Sebastian gets himself in enough trouble. He doesn't need your help. Sebastian is going to get an earful about this.
Ah, I want to help you, but I first want to see what's going on with these quests first. So this must be... This is technically, I guess, still a part of what I need to do, so...
Come and see me as soon as you can. I've returned from a rather unproductive trip to the Ministry, hoping your time has been more fruitful than mine.
What are you up to now?
I really love my character's outfit, man.
Wingardium Leviosa. It can be used to levitate objects for a short time. Once you've completed a few prerequisite tasks, do see me after class.
Oh my god, everyone wants to teach me cool spells. And I want to learn them all. Professor Fig, as if my schedule wasn't congested enough, the Ministry has charged me with arranging the rather inconvenient arrival of a new student at Hogwarts, a fifth year if you can believe. Professor Weasley insists that they will need an escort and a mentor to help them acclimatize before term begins. I have assigned the task to you. Please see Professor Weasley for details. Professor Phineas Nigelius Black, Headmaster. Okay. Oh, sorry.
I was hoping to see you.
You're back.
Finally. Minister Spavin talks more than he listens. Ranted on and on about rogue dragons. Wouldn't listen to a word about goblins. Speaking of which...
Listen, Professor. So much happened while you were away. Eldridge Diggory's portrait in the common room told me about his great-niece, Helen.
His great-niece?
Yes, she used to be an Aura. Well, she took me to Azkaban to meet Anne Thisbe.
You went to Azkaban?
Quite an experience. But you see, Anne knew Richard Jackdaw before he died, so I had to find his ghost.
Who on earth is Richard Jackdaw?
He was a student here long ago. Anyway, he told me about a secret cavern. I went there, and right next to Jackdaw's skeleton, I found the missing pages.
You found the pages?
I did. And because Jackdaw had followed the map they contained, when I found the pages, I found the location on the map. Believe it or not, it's a room below Hogwarts.
Why am I not surprised? Shall we?
I was hoping you'd say that. Oh, and we'll need to bring the book. The room is called the Map Chamber, by the way. And a portrait of Percival Rackham awaits us there.
Professor Rackham. I look forward to meeting him. How did
Revelio.
Jackdaw get the pages from the book?
Evidently, Peeves stole them. And Jackdaw stole them from him.
Oh, Peeves.
Revelio.
Travel is always much more enjoyable with a friend.
To think it was beneath us all this time. Map. There's Hogsmeade. And over here, the Forbidden Forest. And, of course, Hogwarts. It's magnificent. If only you were here to see this.
Hello, Professor Rackham. We've placed the book on the pedestal as you asked. And this is my mentor, Professor Fig.
How do you do, Professor Fig? And you, my young friend, see now why you needed to return with the book?
I do. I also see why you refer to this room as the Map Chamber.
That you have come this far tells me that you possess extraordinary magical ability, the potential and power of which will unlock should you prove yourself worthy. The location of each of four trials will, in time, appear on the map. Trials that will test you and give you access to invaluable knowledge. Trials that you must complete on your own. Do you recall the pensive memory you viewed in my vault in Gringotts?
You and your friend Charles spoke of the portkey, and of trials you'd created for one who could see traces of ancient magic.
Precisely. Charles is another of the Keepers, a designation we gave ourselves centuries ago, in light of the knowledge that we have been bound to keep hidden. Until, perhaps, now.
So, the passage from your ruins to Gringotts, everything in the vault, the restricted section, finding this room, none of these was a trial.
They were an important part of the journey, but they were not trials themselves. The fact that you have come this far, however, bodes well. The trials were designed to ensure that the power and knowledge we have kept secret for so long does not fall into the wrong hands. They will test your abilities, both innate and learned. But of equal importance, everything you witness as you complete the trials will inform what you choose to do with all that we share. You will need patience. The trials have much to teach you. It will take time.
I'm afraid we don't have the luxury of time.
We have waited this long, Professor Fig. Surely a few more.
Respectfully, sir, while I do not know the secret you keep, I do know that our young friend here has seen traces. Traces of a powerful dark magic being wielded by goblin kind. And we encountered an uncommonly powerful goblin wielding such magic as we prepared to leave your vault at Gringotts. We may already be too late.
This is grave news, indeed. Young friend, do you trust Professor Fig?
I do.
Then, in the light of your considerable skill and all you have already accomplished, we shall begin. You will find the location of the first trial marked on the map below you. Whilst Professor Fig may assist you in locating the trials, they may be completed only by one with our ability.
Shall we have a look? I know that tower. It's not far. You may have seen it yourself.
I don't think I have. Perhaps your young friend is not as well traveled as you think.
As your mentor, the least I can do is go ahead to make sure it is safe. Join me as soon as you can.
You said that you know that tower. What can you tell me about it?
Not much, I'm afraid. I've passed it dozens of times. It's north of Hogsmeade. My recollection is that it seems abandoned. Clearly, however, the tower conceals more than meets the eye.
I'll find you at the tower as soon as I can.
Until then, be careful, and do not tell anyone where you're going.
Okay, so I have to meet Professor Fig at the tower, but before I do that, I kind of want to grab the other spells. Also, I have new gear, so I want to see. Oh, wait. Is this better? Yes, it is. But we're going to keep the look the same.
It's time you learned, Glacius, the freezing spell. It is an efficient way to cool down a heated situation. But first, I will need you to complete a few tasks. Once you have done that, come and see me.
Okay, so we got a lot of stuff to do. So we need to complete all these tasks to get all these spells. And I'm going to start with Defendo. Defendo, I think that's how you say it. So let's start with Defendo.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Thank you again for delivering those potions to Madame Lawing. Saved me a lot of time and trouble. What can I do for you today? A wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
How inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
I say we just complete all of these and then we'll end the episode and then we'll finish all of them in the next one and start the next story quest. And I also want to say I appreciate everyone for watching, and I also appreciate the votes on my community post, because I did tell me that most of you guys, you know, either or is fine with you, and also most of you will like to see 45 minute long videos, which makes it super easier on me, and on top of that I get to enjoy playing without stopping every few minutes, so thank you so much, guys.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Whew. Sorry I'm in a bit of a tizzy. I was just scolding some of the plants for spitting and nipping. I suppose it's my own fault for putting more than four to a tray. By the way, Beatrice Green is the name, but
You may address me as Madam Green. Welcome to Dogweed and Deathcap. Oh, mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there wasn't the constant demand for antidotes, I wouldn't need to stalk so many of the little dears. Except, of course, for curses. And, well, if you've been petrified, then obviously you've come to the right place. Mind you don't knock the mandrakes. Oh, if there's an uprooting, you'll be the next one to drop dead, and I'm in no mood for a clear-up.
Someone died here?
Aye. Fortunate, really, that it was just the one. Now then, how may I help you today?
I think I'll just have a look around for now.
Very well. Let me know if you see anything you like.
What do you have for sale?
Well, what say we show you some of what's available? Oh, I'm always thrilled when a young one makes a wise purchase. I can tell you'll go far. But your things will be safe with me until they're sold. Then you'll have to make do with money. Doors always open. You be sure to stop by soon. Such a wee bairn gaeing a thrashing to a throne. I can't believe it.
Hogsmeade, here I come. Who lived here, I wonder? It's all finished. Brilliant.
How did you get on with those tasks?
Madam Kagawa, I completed the list of tasks you assigned.
Wonderful. I trust you became more familiar with your broom through the process?
Yes, Professor.
That's good to hear. Keep it up, and perhaps one day you'll have a spot on the Quidditch team. If Black ever permits Quidditch again. Well, with those tasks out of the way, let us get started. Glacius. Pay attention to your wand work. Well done. I'd recommend that you practice your new spell here in my office before taking it out into the world.
Glacius!
There you go. Kitchen room quickly.
Good sir.
Okay, so let's get the other spells too, might as well, and then we start the next one on a brand new story quest, which will be pretty sweet. So let's get Defendo.
Have you finished your assignments?
I finished the tasks, Professor.
Well, well. I trust you are meticulous in your efforts. After all, shortcuts only ever lead to shortcomings.
Yes, sir, of course.
Good. Ordinarily, I'd say it's not my concern either way, but you... I want to make sure you're well prepared. Talent and resolve are a potent combination. It would be a shame to let that go to waste.
Thank you, Professor.
Don't let it go to your head. Now, let's see how you fare with Defindo. Wand at the ready.
Focus. Defindo can be dangerous if you're not paying attention. Very good. It seems you have a grasp on Defindo.
Defindo!
It's a pleasure to have a student who actually heeds instruction.
Now we have Defindo. Now the next thing is Wingardium Leviosa, dude. We're getting a bunch of spells in this one.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
Professor, what made you want to teach herbology?
Of you to ask. I've always had an affinity for greenery, so this situation is a bit of a dream come true. After graduation, I was thrilled to be asked to step in for my old herbology professor. He'd had a slight accident, you see.
Oh dear. A shame for him, but it worked out well for you.
Well, he never cared, really cared for the plants, and they could sense it. Oh, you'd be surprised how perceptive a plant can be. At any rate, the trouble began one day when he cut into a wigan tree. Unfortunately for him, its leaves were hiding a bow truckle. You may recall the marvelous creatures that resemble a twig. The little beast gouged the professor's eyes quite fiercely, but terrifying, I'd imagine. Likely for the professor, too.
And that's when you took over as the herbology professor?
Well, not quite. After 3 weeks at St. Mungo's, my predecessor regained a tiny bit of his eyesight. He insisted on returning to the greenhouse. Within a week, he claims, by accident, kicked a Chinese chomping cabbage, so it was back to St. Mungo's for him.
Fair bit of bad luck there, I'd say.
Well, I felt awful for him, but I dare say I felt a bit more sympathy for the cabbage. Upon his discharge from the hospital, his indifference to plants had turned to utter disdain. He lost what little patience he had left with a particularly temperamental venomous tentacula and, well, his resulting leave of absence continues to this day.
I had no idea. How awful.
Last I heard, he'd gone to Romania. As rumor would have it, he developed a sudden interest in dragons. One can only hope he found more happiness working with them than he did with Flora. Ha! Lovely speaking with you. Have a wonderful day. Oh, and remember, be kind to your wigan trees.
Oh, she's so fine. Alright, I can't wait to take this class. Let's go.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Ready to learn Arresto Momentum, the slowing charm. It allows you to freeze objects or people in midair.
Wonderful to see you again.
I've completed my assignments, Professor.
Pleased to hear it. Professor Weasley will be too. I'll be sure to let her know how well you're coming along.
Thank you, Professor.
Professor Hecate tells me she taught you Levioso, so you should be ready for a more advanced levitation charm. Wingardium Leviosa requires a bit of concentration and a nice, graceful wand movement. Let's see you try your hand at it. When executed correctly, you should be able to pick up boulders as though they were sprigs of sneezewort.
Oh my god, dude. I'm having straight up psyops. Like, this is psyops, bro. If you can chuck it with the joystick, that would have been sick, dude. So it seems like there's one more spell to learn, so why not just take the extra initiative and just let's end this episode with one more. Arresto momentum! Practice flying near this spell. Okay, this might take a while, so let's actually wait on that one. So on that note, guys, we're gonna actually end this one here, and then I'm gonna start the next episode on the next story quest. So with that said, I've said that a few times, but with that said, thank you so much for watching. My name is The Walking Target. Leave a like and a subscribe. No comments, you know how we do around here. And I will see you in the next one.